Repousse part 2. It's time to move forward with our projects by burnishing our textures and duplicating the effect onto paper. This part of the assignment can be very confusing because you have two different features to choose from, color and texture. For example, silver side versus color side, and convex texture versus concave texture. The way to remember the difference between concave and convex is that concave is beveled in, because you walk into a cave. Convex is beveled out. Depending on the side that you place the pressure on will be the concave side. This example that I am showing you has a silver side which its textures are convex, and the color side its textures are concave. With this example I have decided to do the convex texture, which is the silver side. The next step is to burnish the foil, but before we do that, we need to cover the foil with India ink. To do these steps, you will need a paintbrush, India ink, steel wool, paper towel, vinyl paper, and glue. When using the India ink, you must be very careful with it. It is very permanent. It will ruin clothes, so be very careful. With that in mind, you will need to use a piece of paper towel to place under your foil, so you keep it off of the table. Also, remember to clean your paintbrush really well after you get done using it. To apply the Indian ink, all you have to do is take your brush, dip it into the ink container, and brush it onto your foil. Make sure that you cover as much of the foil as possible. It takes about 20 minutes to dry, so place it on the dry rack and patiently wait. Now that it is dry, now it's time to burnish the foil. Burnishing means to polish by rubbing. This is what you will be doing. You'll be rubbing the ink off the foil. You are doing this so that some areas of the foil will be dark and some areas will be very light. One thing to remember while you are rubbing with the steel wool is that the texture that you placed in by applying pressure can be taken away by applying pressure. In this part of the assignment, you are not wanting to take the texture away, so do not push with the steel wool. It does not take pressure to take away the ink. If you slowly see your texture going away, that means you are pushing too hard. As you can see in the video, I am rubbing in one direction. I feel that this is best for craftsmanship's sake. The rubbing does not take the focus away from the texture. Plus, you'll be asked to color in the same direction, and it will look better if you color in the same direction in which you rubbed. Now you see the difference in value of the foil after burnishing. Once the burnishing is complete to how you like it, you must glue the uninked side to your final paper. Now, with liquid glue, you must be careful. Do not be messy. Do not let the glue seep out of the edges of the foil. If it does, the last thing you want to do is rub it. Just let it dry. When you put glue on the foil, make sure that you keep it away from the edges. When placing the foil onto the paper, you get to decide how you want to place it, but you must make sure that all corners and sides of the foil are on the paper. Do not let any of the foil hang off the sides of the paper. While you are waiting for the glue to dry, you can get started on drawing your textures from the foil to the paper. It is your assignment to extend the textures off the foil onto the paper. You are trying to duplicate it as best as possible. You are trying to have a perfect match. As you can see, I am starting with my four lines that separate the four different textures. Also, you can see I am drawing extremely light. I do this so that I can easily fix any mistakes by easily erasing my light lines. Also, the assignment consists of me going back over my finished lines with black colored pencil, so I'm going to darken them later. I drew so light I had to change the contrast of the video so you could see what I was doing. Again, I'm making sure that my duplication of texture is accurate, that my lines are light and neatly done. Since this example is a convex example, the convex lines are the lighter pieces to the project. This means that when I go back over my lines with black colored pencil, in order for the texture to be accurate, I need to double my lines. Doubling my lines will keep my textures white rather than black when tracing with the colored pencil. As you can see, I am doubling my lines and trying to keep the thickness accurate to the thickness of the textured line on the foil. And I'm coloring around it so that you can see that the textured line would stay white. Now the difference between a convex side to a concave side is that the lightest parts are the convex lines on the convex textured side. On the concave side, the lines are the darkest areas because when burnishing with steel wool, the steel wool did not reach inside the concave textures. In order to do the concave duplication from foil to paper to be accurate, you need to trace over your pencil lines with black colored pencil and make the line the same thickness as the concaved lines on the foil. Some people may think that doing the concaved might be a little easier. Now you can see that I am now going back over my light pencil lines with black colored pencil, and I am doubling all of my lines. Now this is going to take a little while, and I'm going to put it into fast motion here in a second, but again, it's extremely important that you realize that we're trying to make an exact duplication from foil to paper. So very carefully, I'm making my doubled lines the same thickness as the textured lines on my convex side. Now that I've doubled all of my lines, and they are my lightest part, now it's time to color. And one thing to remember when coloring is that gradual value change is the key component. Because again, we're trying to duplicate the look from the foil onto paper. So therefore, we're kind of given an abstraction of how light reacts to the foil. So in everything that you do, do gradual value change. And here is the example almost done being shown to you.